He strut confidently across the frenzied dance floor. With a quick spritz of cool mint breath spray, he approached the stunningly beautiful woman he had been eyeing for several minutes. His best friend had teased that there was no way he would do it. After all, he had just broken up with his longtime girlfriend only 2 weeks prior. She had dumped him very publicly and had left him utterly humiliated. It was the same day he had received the prognosis from his private physician. It was serious, but not life-threatening. Still, as he stood next to the beautiful woman on the dance floor, his heart pounded nervously against his chest. Surprisingly, she said yes to his invitation to dance. They danced and danced and danced, hardly ever breaking eye contact. They spoke with their every move a deeper and deeper affection for one another. She had spotted him earlier in the night as well. She had hoped he would ask her to dance. As the music led them deeper and deeper into the winter night, they locked lips in a passionate yet refrained kiss. She looked deeply into his eyes, her palm rested on his rugged jaw. She looked in love for the first time. She looked as if she had imagined their entire lives together on the dance floor. What their wedding would look like. How many children they would have. Their twilight years spent huddled together on that old porch swing he would someday build when they bought their first house. She stared deeply and passionately into his eyes. "Can I ask you something?" she asked. "You can ask me anything," he replied. "Is that poop on your shoes?" she asked, taking a step back from him. "I have to tell you something," he said, reaching for her hand. "I have a disease," he said. "A disease?" she asked, shocked at this news. "Well, maybe not a disease," he said. "More like a condition," he continued. She stepped closer and rested her head on his bosom. "Tell me," she said, with tears in her eyes. "I have squirty butt," he replied, pooping himself again. She pulled away. "You shall never again see my face nor taste again these my lips," she declared, racing past him and slipping in the doo-doo at his feet.